Now for our What in the World segment. We live in remarkable times where just about everything around us is connected to the internet or soon will be. The World Economic Forum, citing research, says that by the early 2020s, the Internet of Things will consist of 50 billion objects using 1 trillion sensors to collect every imaginable piece of data about us every second of the day. From our cars to our refrigerators, from our doorbells to devices implanted into our bodies, from the shoes on some people's feet to the light bulbs in their lamps. Each one can be constantly sending information back and forth to the supercomputers in our pockets, to each other, and to the cloud. Here's the bad news. Now that all these computerized devices are ubiquitous and interconnected, we've become much more vulnerable, and the dangers of abuse have become considerably greater. This Internet of Things can now shatter our privacy, steal from our wallets, and even threaten our lives. If a country like the United States can't protect its major businesses and infrastructure from hack attacks, how can you protect your internet-connected fridge from hackers who can then get into your bank account? Look at what happened recently when ransomware going by the name of WannaCry locked up hundreds of thousands of computers around the world. Hospitals, train systems, and factories were all crippled by hackers taking advantage of a vulnerability in Microsoft's operating system. Not surprisingly, banks are often the main targets of cyber criminals. Just one example. Back in 2016, cyber thieves, allegedly using a flaw in the computerized systems that banks use to talk with one another, attempted to electronically steal almost $1 billion from the Bangladesh Central Bank. The hackers got away with transferring $81 million out of the bank before being stopped. JP Morgan Chase has said it spent $600 million in 2016 on cybersecurity, up from $250 million in 2014. And at a security summit in 2015, Ginni Rometty, the head of IBM, said, "Cybercrime, by definition, is the greatest threat to every profession, every industry, every company in the world." According to one 2014 estimate, the annual global cost of cybercrime was at least $375 billion. And that cost could balloon to $2.1 trillion by 2019. Not surprisingly, cybercrimes also represent a measurable percentage of GDP. In the US, it's 0.64%. But in the Netherlands, cybercrime accounts for as much as 1.5% of the GDP. In Germany, it's 1.6%. But back to all of those internet-connected things. Love the idea of sitting back and relaxing while your self-driving car takes you on your next appointment? Well, back in 2015, independent security researchers working with a Wired magazine reporter for a story remotely hacked the dashboard computer of a Jeep Cherokee from a laptop 10 miles away. Demonstrating a software vulnerability many new cars have, the researchers were able to hijack the braking systems, forcing the Jeep to drive into a ditch.
Hold on.
It should be noted that Jeep's parent company said there has not been a single real-world incident of an unlawful or unauthorized remote hack into any of its vehicles. But the demonstration was able to show that the potential now exists for hackers or terrorists to remotely disable a car's brakes, lock the doors, and steer passengers right off a cliff. The problem is that in our rush to connect everything, we've created a monster that's just waiting to take advantage of a broken line of code or a missing software patch. And the interconnectivity of the web has made it all too easy to inadvertently let cyber criminals into our homes, our cars, and our bank accounts. We need to find some sort of balance between access and security, and until that happens, hackers will be seeking the next opportunity to digitally wreak havoc with our physical world.